Good day and welcome to Big Bad Tech. I'm instructor Jim Pytel, and today we'll learn to configure multifunction digital output on the Omron 3G3JX-AE004 motor drive. This lecture is predicated on the assumption that viewers watch the adjusting motor drive ramping characteristics featuring the Omron 3G3JX-AE004 motor drive lecture available at the Big Bad Tech channel. If you haven't watched this lecture yet or only dimly recall its contents, please take the time to do so now. Additionally, since we'll be dealing with this particular manufacturer's parameter programming process and navigation within it, it may help to download the associated datasheet and or user manual. Before making use of the Omron 3G3JX-AE004 motor drive, we'll initialize the drive to a default state and clear any errors using the initialization and protection parameter B084. Then, we'll program it to recognize a 200-watt motor with a nominal rotational speed of 1800 RPM using the motor settings parameters H003 and H004. Finally, we'll program the drive to recognize an external speed potentiometer input using extended function parameter A001. This start state establishes a 60 Hz base frequency, a 60 Hz maximum frequency, forward default rotation, a linear volts per hertz ratio, a 10-second linear acceleration time, and a 10-second linear deceleration time, among other properties. This motor drive is now ready for today's activities. In this application exercise, we'll learn to configure both the multifunction digital output P1 and the multifunction electromechanical relay. Let's examine multifunction digital output P1 first. Multifunction digital output P1 appears at the far right of the long strip of terminals associated with its common connection, PC. The default state between PC and P1 is normally open, however, this is user adjustable. Depending on the function assigned to P1, this digital output can be used as a feedback signal for other elements within a larger system. In this application exercise, we'll set it up such that P1 selectively energizes or de-energizes a 24-volt DC rated pilot lamp. We'll wire the indicator lamp such that P1 performs low side switching and that the 24-volt DC pilot lamp has continual connection to the internal 24-volt DC supplied by the drive P24 terminal. By tying together the PC common terminal to that of the FC common terminal, when P1 is in the default open state, no connection exists and the pilot lamp remains unilluminated. When P1 closes, a connection is established and the pilot lamp would illuminate. First, tie together terminal FC and PC. The black spiraled wire serves this purpose. Next, route the internal 24-volt DC power supply from the P24 terminal and the P1 multifunction digital output terminal out of the motor drive. The yellow spiraled wire and the blue spiraled wire respectively serve this purpose. These connections respectively go to the high and low side of the indicator. Note this pilot lamp is 24-volt DC rated. Now we need to configure multifunction digital output P1. The Omron 3G3JX-AE004 motor drive does so using communication parameter C021. Multifunction output terminal P1 selection. Numerous functions are available, only a handful of which we'll examine today. 00, the default setting, signals when the motor drive is in run mode, either accelerating, at constant speed, or decelerating. 01 is the constant speed arrival signal. This setting signals when the acceleration period is over and the motor has reached the desired speed. 03 is the overload warning signal. This setting signals the system or operator that current draw is in excess of some pre-programmed value. The other available functions indicate other important feedback or error conditions. First, let's navigate to communication parameters C021, multifunction output terminal P1 selection. As expected, it's in the default state of 00, or run, which signals when the motor drive is in run mode, either actively accelerating, at constant speed, or decelerating. Let's see the setting in operation. When an operator presses run, pilot lamp switched by the multifunction digital output P1 in 00 run mode illuminates during the acceleration period. While in constant speed mode, the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 in 00 run mode remains illuminated. When an operator presses stop, the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 in 00 run mode remains illuminated during the active deceleration period. Only after the controlled deceleration period has ended does the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 in 00 run mode turn off. While unimpressive for this brief experiment, consider this pilot lamp indicator could be used in some remote location, allowing an operator or technician to monitor the status of the drive without actually having to be physically present. Additionally, the multifunction digital output P1 needn't be switching a pilot lamp on or off, but rather signaling some other element or collection of elements within a larger system to turn on or off whenever this particular drive is running. Let's see if we can change the function performed by multifunction digital output P1. Navigate to communication parameter C021, multifunction output terminal P1 selection. Increment to 01, or the constant speed arrival function. This setting signals when the acceleration period is over and when the motor has reached the desired speed. Let's see the setting in operation. When an operator presses run, the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 in constant speed arrival mode remains unilluminated during the acceleration period. As expected, the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 in 01 constant speed arrival mode illuminates only when speed stabilizes. When an operator presses stop, the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 in 01 constant speed arrival mode turns off during the deceleration period. Really, the only difference between run and at speed mode is that the run mode asserts multifunction digital output P1 whenever the motor drive is running, either accelerating at constant speed or decelerating, whereas the at speed mode only asserts multifunction digital output P1 when at constant speed, as we'd expect. Let's examine yet another function of multifunction digital output P1, 03, overload warning. First, we need to know what current this motor draws while in operation. Note I've disabled the pilot lamp for this portion of the exercise. With parameter D002, output current monitor being displayed, when an operator presses run, during acceleration, current kind of peaks out at around maybe 1.7-ish amps. While in constant speed mode, the motor appears to be drawing 1.2 to 1.1-ish amps. When an operator presses stop, during deceleration, current kind of peaks out at maybe 1.3-ish amps. Let's adjust a related communication parameter, C041, overload warning level, to an unusually small level to trigger the warning even during an unloaded condition. Note the overload warning level is exactly that, a warning, and not an indicator of an actual overload where the drive takes action to correct it. We'll learn to examine and adjust protection parameters in later applications exercise that not only warn of overloads, but also take action to respond or correct an overload. Navigate to communication parameter C041, overload warning level. The default warning level is the rated output of this drive, in this case 2.6 amps, as indicated on the label affixed to the side of the drive. Decrement this value to, let's say, 1.1 amps and press enter to save it. Navigate back to communication parameter C021, multifunction output terminal P1 selection. Increment to 03, or the overload warning function. This setting signals when current draws in excess of the adjustable communication parameter C041, overload warning level, currently set at 1.1 amps. If you're tracking, you should be able to predict the behavior of this pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 in 03, overload warning mode during acceleration, constant speed, and deceleration. Let's see the overload warning function in operation. With parameter D002, output current monitor being displayed, when an operator presses run during acceleration, whenever current is in excess of 1.1 amps, the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 executing the overload warning function illuminates. When in constant speed mode, the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 executing the overload warning function kind of flutters on and off as current vacillates around 1.2 to 1.1-ish amps. When an operator presses stop, when current drops below 1.1 amps, the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 executing the overload warning function turns off. Obviously, an overload warning of 1.1 amps is way too low given this motor is unloaded. However, a technician can change the overload warning level and enable this function to get early notice of potential overload and take necessary action. Moving on, the Omron 3G3JX-AE004 motor drive has more than one multifunction output. The electromechanical relay output can also be programmed to perform numerous functions. The electromechanical relay output is still digital in nature, but it's different than the multifunction digital output P1 in that it's electromechanical in nature and can switch other external devices with different current ratings. For example, 120 volt AC control signals or even line-to-line voltage necessary for proper operation of a spring-applied electrical release friction brake solenoid. The electromechanical relay output is a single-pole double-throw transfer contact defined by three terminals, MC, the common, MA, the normally closed side, and MB, the normally open side. Note the defined states of these contacts are determined when the motor drive is powered up with the primary input terminals. We'll start by wiring up the normally open side to switch a 120 volt AC rated pilot lamp. Again, note that the electromechanical relay is switching something other than 24 volt DC signals. We'll keep P1 low side switching the same 24 volt DC pilot lamp. To wire in the 120 volt AC rated pilot lamp, we'll grab the X1 output of a 120 volt AC control transformer. The red spiraled wire serves this purpose. We'll land the red spiraled wire on the MC common terminal of the electromechanical relay. We'll come out of the normally open MB terminal. The blue spiraled wire serves this purpose. The blue spiraled wire goes into the high side of the 120 volt AC rated pilot lamp. Black spiraled wire comes out of the low side of the 120 volt AC rated pilot lamp. The black spiraled wire is landed on the grounded X2 output of a 120 volt AC control transformer. The multifunction electromechanical relay output can perform the exact same functions as multifunction digital output P1, specifically 00, run, which signals when the motor drive is in run mode, 01, the constant speed arrival signal, 03, an overload warning signal, and 05, alarm, the default setting, to name a few. The other available functions indicate other important feedback or error conditions. To configure the multifunction electromechanical relay output, a technician does so using communication parameter C026, relay output function selection. Navigate to communication parameter C026. As expected, it's in the default 05 or alarm mode. Let's decrement it to perform 00, the run function. Press enter to save this value. With both the multifunction electromechanical relay and multifunction digital output P1 performing the 00 run function, we should observe both pilot lamps switch on whenever the motor drive is in run mode, either accelerating, at constant speed, or decelerating. The difference being that the top pilot lamp is 120 volt AC rated, is being high side switched by the multifunction electromechanical relay, and the bottom pilot lamp is only 24 volt DC rated and is being low side switched by the multifunction digital output P1. Let's see if this is the case. When an operator presses run, both pilot lamps executing the run function illuminate as expected. While in constant speed mode, both pilot lamps executing the run function remain illuminated. When operator presses stop, both pilot lamps executing the run function remain illuminated during the deceleration period. Only after the controlled deceleration period is ended do both pilot lamps performing the run function turn off. Let's see if we can change the function of the multifunction electromechanical relay to 01, constant speed arrival function. Navigate to communication parameter C026. Increment it to 01, constant speed arrival. Press enter to save this value. Note multifunction digital output P1 remains in 00, run mode. When an operator presses run, only the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 executing the run function turns on as expected. While in constant speed mode, the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 executing the run function remains illuminated, and the pilot lamp switched by the multifunction electromechanical relay executing the constant speed arrival function comes on. You can hear the characteristic click of the electromechanical relay making physical contact. When an operator presses stop, while the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 executing the run function remains illuminated during the deceleration period, the pilot lamp switched by the multifunction electromechanical relay executing the constant speed arrival function turns off. Only after the controlled deceleration period has ended does the pilot lamp switched by multifunction digital output P1 performing the run function turn off. Given the two pilot lamps switched by two different multifunction outputs performing two different functions, maybe remotely located, or perhaps signaling some other inaccessible portion of a larger system, the Omron 3G3JX-AE004 motor drive allows a means of directly monitoring the output status of both P1 and the electromechanical relay. A technician does so by navigating to the monitor or display function D006, Multifunction Output Monitor. The data display shows two indicators. The one on the right is P1. The one on the left is the electromechanical relay. Both indicators, being on the bottom half of the data display, show that both P1 and the electromechanical relay are not currently energized. When an operator presses run, the data display indicates P1 executing the run function is energized, and the electromechanical relay executing the constant speed arrival function is de-energized. While in constant speed mode, the data display indicates both P1 executing the run function and the electromechanical relay executing the constant speed arrival function are energized. When an operator presses stop, the data display indicates P1 executing the run function is energized, and the electromechanical relay executing the constant speed arrival function is de-energized. Only after the controlled deceleration period is ended does the data display indicate both P1 executing the run function and the electromechanical relay executing the constant speed arrival function are de-energized. This means of directly monitoring the status of multifunction outputs is infinitely useful for troubleshooting purposes when the output is remotely located or otherwise inaccessible. Before we bring this lecture to a close, note that not only are these two multifunction digital outputs executing different user-customizable functions, it must be emphasized they're switching two different styles of electrical loads. Multifunction digital output P1 is low-side switching a 24-volt DC control signal internally generated by the motor drive, whereas the multifunction electromechanical relay is high-side switching a 120-volt AC control signal that is externally generated. Is this cool or what? The multifunction electromechanical relay output can therefore be used as an interface with other electrical loads or other systems necessitating different levels of control voltage. Perhaps nowhere is the application of a multifunction electromechanical relay more important than in coordinating the action of a spring-applied electrical release friction brake used to positively lock a de-energized motor in place. For example, consider a motor drive that needs to execute a controlled acceleration and deceleration, in which applied voltage and excitation frequency is ramped over a user-customizable acceleration and deceleration time for the purposes of a soft start and soft stop. However, the brake solenoid necessitates full line-to-line voltage to energize the brake solenoid to completely disengage the friction brake. The multifunction electromechanical relay output solves this voltage mismatch by simply switching the full line-to-line voltage when signaled to do so by the motor drive. I hereby present you this quick challenge. Of the functions we examined today, run, constant speed arrival, and overload warning, which function should this multifunction electromechanical relay output be assigned to fully release the spring-applied electrical release friction brake with full line-to-line voltage the moment the motor begins the acceleration period, throughout the constant speed operation, and keeps it disengaged until the deceleration period is ended? If you said something that rhymes with fun, you're correct. Keep in mind that the voltage and current rating of the multifunction electromechanical relay output must be taken into consideration when switching line-to-line voltage. Instead of directly making or breaking connection to full line-to-line voltage, the multifunction electromechanical relay output could indirectly do so by energizing or de-energizing the pilot coil of an appropriately rated contactor. We'll examine other deceleration and braking methods employed by motor drives in later lectures. Until then, that's about it for this short applications exercise. In conclusion, we learned to configure the two multifunction digital outputs on the Omron 3G3JX-AE004 motor drive. We learned communication parameter C021, multifunction output terminal P1 selection, changed the function of multifunction digital output P1, and that communication parameter C026, relay output function selection, changes the functions of an electromechanical relay. Either of these two multifunction digital outputs can perform the run function, the constant speed arrival signal, the overload warning signal, which signals the system or operator that the current draw is in excess of some pre-programmed value, or other warning or feedback functions. Additionally, we learned how to program communication parameter C041 over the warning level to signal whenever current draw is in excess of this value. We also learned to directly monitor the status of the two multifunction outputs using the monitor display function D006, multifunction output monitor. Directly monitoring the status of multifunction outputs is infinitely useful for troubleshooting purposes when the output is remotely located or otherwise inaccessible. Finally, we discuss how the multifunction electromechanical relay output can be used to switch other electrical loads like spring applied, electric release, friction brakes. Remember to review these concepts as often as you need to really drive it home. Imagine how well lab will go if you know what you're doing. Thank you very much for your attention and interest, and we'll see you again in the next lecture of our series. Remember to tell your Lazy Lab partner about this resource, and be sure to check out the Big Bad Tech channel for additional resources and updates.